Welcome to Pray With Me, a daily prayer time with Father Alphonse. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I would like to pray for married couples, engaged couples, as it is Valentine's Day today, Sunday, the 14th February. Psalm 40. Surely I wait for the Lord, who bends down to me and hears my cry, draws me up from the pit of destruction, out of the muddy clay, sets my feet upon rock, steadies my steps, and puts a new song in my mouth, a hymn to our God. Many shall look on in fear, and they shall trust in the Lord. Blessed the man who sets his security in the Lord, who turns not to the arrogant or to those who stray after falsehood. You, yes, you, O Lord, my God, have done many wondrous deeds. And in your plans for us, there is none to equal you. Should I wish to declare or tell them, too many are they to recount. Sacrifice and offering you do not want. You opened my ears. Holocaust and sin offering you do not request. So I said, see, I come with an inscribed scroll written upon me. I delight to do your will. My God, your law is in my inner being. When I sing of your righteousness in a great assembly, see, I do not restrain my lips as you, Lord, know. I do not conceal your righteousness within my heart. I speak of your loyalty and your salvation. I do not hide your mercy or faithfulness from a great assembly. Lord, may you not withhold your compassion from me. May your mercy and your faithfulness continually protect me. But evil surround me until they cannot be counted. My sins overtake me so that I can no longer see. They are more numerous than the hairs of my head. My courage fails me. Lord, graciously rescue me. Come quickly to help me, Lord. May those who seek to destroy my life be shamed and confounded. Turn back in disgrace those who desire my ruin. Let those who say to me, aha, be made desolate on account of their shame, while those who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who long for your salvation always say, the Lord is great. Though I am afflicted and poor, my Lord keeps me in mind. You are my help and deliverer. My God, do not delay. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Friends, God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. We know that from saying it during the Mass, but the psalmist in the same lines says, God is great all the time. All the time, God is great. As we are praying for the married couple or couples or the engaged couples, my sincere request for all of you is that you seek the Lord and long for salvation and say and proclaim the Lord is great together. Marriage is a sacrament of service, serving each other, man and wife, and wife and man. And together they serve the church, and that's how you can glorify the Lord. And so when you serve, you have to be ready to submit yourself to each other in good times and in bad, in suffering and in good health. At all times, you love each other, be faithful to each other. And that is the key, that you love and be faithful and look upon each other for mutual help. And together, if you are cemented with God's grace and God's presence, there is no danger that your marriage be turbulent. You will see that you get across this storm that rises in life. And so don't get discouraged. The Lord bends down to hear your cry. See, that's what the psalmist says at the beginning. Surely I wait for the Lord who bends down to me and hears my cry. Should you have any problems in your marital life, trust in God and seek Him, seek His salvation and seek His help, and the Lord will certainly bend down to help you. Let us pray. Lord God, we offer our prayers for the married couples, the engaged couples, that they may learn to love each other purely as Jesus has loved His church, giving Himself entirely to His bride, and the bride loving Jesus from the beginning and forever. May they have understanding, forgiveness, patience, and all the gifts of the Holy Spirit that will help to serve each other and serve the church and to give You glory. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thank you for joining me in this prayer. If you are blessed by this time of prayer, please click on the like, share, or subscribe button and share with others. May God bless you. It's all you got to live.